There you are. I was just thinking about you. And that delicious moment we shared the other night. Pity. You're tastier than you know. And you were my first. In all these years, I've only ever fed on beasts. Drinking the blood of thinking creatures is a different thing entirely. You were delectable. And now I can't help but wonder how the others taste. Oh, you're a sweetheart. But you don't need to worry. I'm just thinking out loud. Take Gale, for example. He strikes me as someone whose blood is rich, refined, like well-aged brandy. But the Gith, what in the hells would she taste like? Oh. Well, that sounds very appealing. I'm almost convinced. Relax. We're just talking. So, in the spirit of theoretical questions, if you had to take a bite from one of them, who would it be? Oh, no. No, 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 no. Don't be disgusting. I just mean a sip of their blood. No mastication required. A brave choice. Although, the more I think on it, the hungrier I get. I better go find something I can actually get my teeth into. Don't tempt me, darling. Need something? Oh, darling, I'm hurt. I thought we had something special. I guess I'll spend my evenings lounging here while you do all the hard work. It sounds awful.
Speak. It is done.
A trap. Time to dance.
Weapon blueprints. They call for Sousa bark. There's only one place I'm finding a Sousa tree. The Underdark. Webs carry vibrations.
Thank you. camp life seems to suit the young owlbear. His coat of feathers seems fuller. His eyes look bright and inquisitive.
Well, my day just improved. Did you want something? Very serious of you. But go ahead. It's strange. I've been dwelling on what I told you before about wanting to become a Dark Justicia. But perhaps I should be content with my lot. I'm already blessed to have you at my side, after all. Well, my day just improved. Did you want something? Huh. So, that's what people mean when they talk about butterflies in their stomach. Did you want something? Well, my day just improved. Did you want something? Fine. What's on your mind? Quite splendidly, to give credit where it's due. You and I have shared some good times together, and it seems we have plenty in common. Very serious of you. But go ahead. It's strange. I've been dwelling on what I told you before about wanting to become a Dark Justicia. Perhaps I should be content with my lot. I'm already blessed to have you at my side, after all.
Looking at something? I'm looking too, but not seeing very much. Another quirk of my affliction. Preening in the looking glass. Petty vanity. Of course I miss it. I've never even seen this face. Not since it grew fangs and my eyes turned red. I don't know. I can't remember. My face is just some dark shape in my past. Another thing I've lost. What? I want to know what the world sees when it looks at me. What you see. Excuse me, I'm an eternally young vampire, not your doting grandmother. You can do better. What else? This is meant to be flattery, not poetry. Just tell me I'm beautiful and we can call it a day. How dare you? I thought we had something special. Still, you're nice too. I better get some beauty sleep. It seems I need it if I'm to catch up with the competition.
Shadow's ranks. The bones of the careless are probably littered down there.
These boots have seen everything. Press ahead. I'm fading fast. I must heal. So much for peace. On my way.
Cool.
Thank you.
Injuries need tending.
Read all about them, but never seen one up close before. The magic is old and wavering, but you recognize it. The mirror is a thinking lock, hiding some secret. The face is crafted to be pleasing, but the personality is just a reflection of the wizard that created it.
Speak your name. I give you our known to my master. Step forward and declare
on what you recognize. Zastam is a powerful lich that rules the land of Thay. He drove many red wizards out of their ancestral home.
You are no Zolkir, but are you wise? Tell me, why might one use balsam ointment? Acceptable. Finally. If you could see anything in me, what would it be? You seek to survive. You seek power. Be welcome.
Another step forward.
A well-guarded laboratory. What were they hiding down here?
How you go? There's a trap.
The book is locked tight with no visible keyhole, only an oval recess in the cover's mouth. You try to examine the book, but the longer you stare, the more those piercing amethyst eyes draw you in. You've seen similar books in wizards' libraries. A tome on Thayan magic, a rare and expensive find. But people have gone mad reading less dangerous texts.
A cursed book? How obvious. Whoever opens it deserves the fate that befalls them.
Curious. Why don't you take a closer look? I'll observe from back here.
Please don't open the creepy book.
Irresistible. You feel changed, bettered for having opened it. Suddenly you are capable of anything. Felling mountains, darkening suns, conversing with the dead. Glyphs shift gently before your eyes. Words slip into your mind, onto your lips, forming words you don't understand. And something is trying to reply. Move aggressively, probing your mental defenses. But you hold strong. For now. The world around you is gone. You can only see those glyphs, only hear those voices. You feel claws moving in the shadows. They pull at you, dragging you closer. Glyphs scream, branding your mind with strange runes. You see time rewritten, fate undone, your future thrumming with power. You struggle to cling to scraps of what you know. Powerful necromancy, you're sure. But it darts away, leaving only hell's screams. The book snaps closed. You've seen too much. What profane knowledge is now seared inside of you, you should never have known.
Never wanted the easy path.
You've seen much of the book, but its most powerful secrets are guarded by indecipherable glyphs. Without a key, they may be locked away forever.
Ah!
What now? Breathe deep and move.
The dog wags his tail, a small bag clenched between his teeth. He gives in and surrenders his find to you. Scratch's tongue lolls out happily, his tail wagging even faster.